In this text ring jewelry CAD tutorial mini series number 2, I'm going to show you two things. Number 1, how to design a script text that is suitable for metal casting. Number 2, how to flow the design into a ring band. Let's get started. To work with this kind of style, you will need to find a text font that is really flowy. So let's take a look on what I have. Let's go to the top view, front view, and then we want to make a ring shank. Let's set the radius for 8, which is 16 millimeter in diameter. Then we can go type the command length, and that will tell us it's 50.265. So I'm going to make 50.265, enter. So the length over here is equal the circumference. Okay, so let's go to the top view and let's go to the text. Font that I'm using is Edwarding Script ITC. That's the font that I downloaded, and I make sure it's bold. Keep in mind that we want to have curve instead of solid. We don't want to group it. You can change the space if you want to, but since I only have two letters, that doesn't matter. So let's click OK. So now we have this one. The reason we want to do the curve is because we need to edit. You can see that the curve is kind of folding to itself, and you will, if you create extruded solid from here, then you will have a problem with it. So let me go ahead and delete some of the points, so that way there will be a continue one single line. The same thing happened right here, so let me go ahead to delete this one as well. Once we deleted it, we want to see if this any part is overlapping. As you can see, some of these coming, the end is coming into the body itself. So what we like to do is I would like to explode this one and have that maybe draw a curve like this, and using this curve to trim this one and this one. Okay, so that way we don't have, you know, this is connected. And then next things I wanted to do is I want to pick up the control point on the bow's end and move it inside of it. And then you can kind of tweak it a little bit if you feel like that is too stiff. But you can, or you can make it thicker or something like that. And then we want to go ahead to use that to trim everything else. So now is a closed curve. Let's go ahead to join this guy here. We also need to enlarge the look as specific on those points. Sometimes those points will cause the problem. Usually what I like to do is make them a little bit rounder. So that's one of the way to delete the control point, or you can kind of give it a fillet there. All right, so we want to go ahead to join the other one there. Alright, so creating the thickness of the border, I'm going to do is to pick up my curve, and then I'm going to the curve tool. Then you have this one, it's called offset. Depends on how fat that you want them to be. Here is setting up for 0.4. I'm just gonna type it 0.5 and giving a little bit more surface there. Okay, and also at the same time, I kind of need to reorient it, the area that I want. Maybe I want them to touching a little bit better. So at this one, I'm going to offset as well the same distance, so I get something like that. So let me kind of move them a little bit, kind of find the best position for them. If that look good to you, that's great, then we're gonna stay with it. At the same time, we want to compare the entire text and how much does it take for the rest of the ring shank. So that means my ring shank might be a little bit too short, so I'm gonna scale it down just a little bit. So you kind of need to look at the proportion and see which one worked the best. Okay, so now we have this. I'm going to have this one and this one as our border if we really like that. Then I'm going to trim this guy over here. So then they will become one single line. Let's go ahead to join them. Okay, so this is our border. This is inside of where it's going to cut it out. I also will like to suggest to give a little bit radius, even like really small, like 0.1 there, to somewhere like this spot, because you try to keep all the sharp corner away so you can avoid a lot of casting issues. So if anything is like too sharp over there, you kind of want to give a little bit radius there. It will not affect the look of the text, but it will giving you much better casting result. And trust me, the little things like this, it may not look like a lot of difference, but it does, you know, giving a lot of benefit for casting. Alright, so you can go ahead and spend more time to make it nice and round, and as you can see, it doesn't show too much from the on the overall effect on the text. Alright, so first things I would like to do is the outer edges. So let's take a look on the perspective. In the perspective, I would like to have this one going up like 2 millimeters, for example. It's pretty thick band, but it is a ring band. I actually want to make sure they are sturdy and solid. So let's go ahead and extrude it up for 2 millimeters. Okay, so now I have this. I'm going to have all the interior that I have there that I'm going to cut it out. So will be the outer text of this guy and this guy. They are going to be cutting inside. So I'm going to have it extruded surface, go to the solid, extruded plane and curve straight, and I want them to go 1 millimeter. Alright, so it's sitting inside of it, but that's moving those two parts. So this extrusion and this extrusion, let's go into move it up 1 more millimeter. Then we're going to use the bowling difference. We are going to bowling difference this outer one out of this inside one. So you kind of see what happened over there. Okay, so now what we need to do, I think this one inside need to be extruded, because it need to be cut out as well. So let's go ahead to extrude it this straight for 1 millimeter. And then again, we want to move in this up with the gumbo for 1 millimeter. Then again, we want a bowling difference this out of this one. Okay, so now they look like something there. We are missing some part in the middle, which is this part and this part. So let's go ahead to solid, extruded plane and straight, and then we want to do a 2 millimeter. Alright, so now we have the center part is done. Let's go ahead to bowling all of them. Okay, now to do the ring shank, it's coming together on the bottom and it's kind of cross really nice on the where is a half of a shank. What we need to do one thing is we need to make sure the beginning and the end is combined together really well. So what I like to do is I'm going to use the line from the midpoint and snapping into the endpoint, and I do want it to have about 1.5 millimeter on each side. So we're gonna do the same thing here, and 1.5 millimeter on each side there. Okay, so what I mean is this point right there will connect to that point. That means if we have those two points with the same profile, supposedly they should meet it really well together. Alright, so let's take a look. I'm going to do something really simple. Let's go with the rectangle, and we want to snap into the endpoint. But let's take a look on the right. I'm going to type it 1.5 times 1.5, so that give me a square over there. And then let's just go ahead to copy this one from the endpoint to this endpoint, the same way from endpoint to this endpoint. So that kind of give us an idea when they coming together, when we kind of flow it back, it should touch where on the bottom. Okay, that's the ideal. Now we need to know how we are going to flow this guy. So I'm gonna go to the top view, and then we are going to snapping into, go back it with the here. I'm going to snapping into the endpoint. Okay, and then you can be creative for what you like to do with this, but I'm going to do something like this here. Okay, and the other one I'm going to go and then like this, and then it will cross and it will end it anywhere in between here. Okay, don't worry about it snapping into somewhere, because it will be, and we will do we'll flatten it back to the construction plane just in a minute. So let's go ahead to do this one, coming cross, coming here, and it's gonna end it somewhere here. And we're gonna have a very last one. It's gonna go again to the endpoint, and then that's going here, here, and then we're gonna end it somewhere here. Okay, and again, we need to make sure that the line is very straight. As you can see now at the front view, they are not on the construction plane. So let's go ahead to pick up this one, this one, this one, and this one, and on the top view, we want to use the command called project to C plane, and we want to delete the original one because we no longer need that. Okay, so now I have something like this. Okay, the next step that we are going to do is I'm gonna pick up this square, and actually you can have it to any type of the cross section, but I'm happen just to use a square because it's easy for you to see. So I'm just gonna copy that one to the endpoint here, to the endpoint here, and also very last one endpoint right there. Okay, so with this one, I wanna make sure that when they come in here, it's not like having a little bit stick it out. So I'm going to rotate this guy so that will fitting into the inside really well. And then we're gonna have something like this, and let's go ahead to moving that part as well over there, and then this part over here. Maybe it's coming out a little bit too much, so kind of hiding there, so it's easier for me to do the bowling. Alright, so now we have this. Let's do a test. We can also do is turn on the record history, and let's go to surface sweep one. This is the rail, this is cross section, and the other one is right there, cross section. And then make sure that they are aligned facing the same direction for the arrow. Then we have the first one is done. Now let's do the second one. Again, record the history. We go from record a history, and then we'll go to the surface sweep one, and this is the rail, this is the cross section, and this is the cross section, and then we have the second one go this way. Okay, now let's go to the third one, and doing the same thing. So I'm going to fast forward here a little bit so you won't feel like now we have this. We just need to make sure that is what we wanted. So I'm going to move the center part align with one of this on the bottom, so that way I can see if the foam coming out from to the text or something like that. Now since we have a record history, and if we don't like the position right there, we can just move it to somewhere else, so it's easier for you to edit later on. Okay, so now I'm going to cap all this guy so they become solid. It will tell you break the history. That's okay, because we no longer need to change it, And then let's go ahead to bowling unit to the center as well. So now we have this is done and we are ready to flow it back to this ring right there. Make sure one thing is, let's take a look on the front view. Make sure that the line that we have, it need to be aligned to the bottom of the text, and let's set it up to the zero. Okay, so let's take a look on that. Everything look good. Let's turn on the perspective. All right, so the very final step is we're gonna go to a transform. We're gonna go flow along curve, and we're gonna pick up the object, and then pick up the base curve, and then we'll come in here to pick up the curve on the ring. So now you see it's coming like that, and the reason it's coming like that is because the that's where the seam is. I'm just gonna simply just turn it like this. All right, so you can kind of see we have this ring and I have a very beautiful flow text and it's coming to the bottom together. I hope you enjoy the video. This is our mini series number 2. There are 2 more coming up. Stay tuned. Please like and comment and share my video so I'm able to share more free video on this channel. Thank you for watching. I will see you next Monday.